गुड मॉर्निंग. इन टूडेज क्लास वी विल बी स्टडिंग अबाउट द एल्गोरिदम्स विच वी डिस्कस दैट देयर आर थ्री एल्गोरिदम्स विच कैन बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड ऑन अ बाइनरी सर्च ट्री, दैट इज सर्चिंग, इंसर्शन एंड डिलीशन. सो दिस थ्री एल्गोरिदम्स वी विल बी स्टडिंग. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सर्च एल्गोरिदम. सपोज आई हैव अ ट्री, अ बाइनरी सर्च ट्री like this, and on this tree I want to search for the value of 2, that is this node I want to search. Now how do we implement this search algorithm? Now this search algorithm, in this search function I will pass two parameters. The first parameter is the value which we want to search for, and the second parameter is the root, that is this value, root of the tree, to indicate from where my tree starts. So what does happen is, say if I, what do we do for searching process? Suppose if I want to search for the value of 2, I start from here and I check whether the root value which I have, is it same to the value which I want to search for? Is 3 equal to 2? If is 3 equal to 2, I will return that the value is searched. If 3 is not equal to 2, then I will check the condition that the value I want to search for, is it greater than my root or is it lesser than my root. If it is greater than my root value, then I will have to search the right subtree part of the root. And again, the value if I want to search for, if it is lesser than my root value, then I will have to search the left subtree part of my root. And again, in that left subtree part also, I will have to search whether the value at the node is that of the value I want to search for. If yes, then I will return the value. If no, then again I will have to check whether the value I want to search, is it greater than the node value or lesser than the node value. If it is lesser than the node value, I will search this part of 1, and if it is greater than the node value, I will search this part of 1. So after I reach there, I will get the final answer that yes, 2 lies over here. So like this, the whole process is done. So in the search function, I pass 2 parameters, the value I want to search from and the root value of the tree to indicate where my tree starts. Now under this section, if my root value, two things can be there. Either my value can be present at the root or a particular node at each iteration which I go to, or the value is not present at all. Two things can be there. So if the root value is equal to null, we will say that the tree is empty. That is, the value is not found. We will return null. Else, if root.data, that is root data, whatever data is at the root, that is equal to our value, that is the item we want to search for. If we get this thing, we will say that our value is found and we will return the root. Else, if our data at the root, if it is greater than the value to be searched, that is here I want to search 2 and the data at the root, it is greater than the value we want to search for, then I will search in the left part of 3. Similarly, if root.data is greater than the value we want to search for, we will apply the same search function with the same value to be searched but on the left subtree part of the root. So root dot left subtree. And if the root dot data is lesser than the value, we will apply the same search function with the same value on the right subtree part, that is root dot right subtree. Right? So in any of the case, either this or this or this or this, any of the 4 cases, only one case can be true at a time. So suppose let us take the example 2. So in the search function, I will pass the value as 2 and the root value will be 3. Now I will check, is 3 equal to null? Is our root equal to null? No, the root is not null because a tree is present. So I will not enter into this if condition. Then I will search if the root dot data, that is if 3 equal to 2. No, this is not the case. So I won't be entering in this if section. Next I will search if root dot data, that is 3 greater than 2. Yes, 3 is greater than 2. So I will implement the search function again on the root dot left subtree, that is 3 dot left subtree, that is left subtree of this root 3. If my root data is greater than the value I want to search for, I will implement the same process in this thing, right? So when I come over here, this part is true. So again I will start from this function. Now when I start from this function, my search value is 2, which I want to search for. But here this root dot left subtree, this value becomes 1, because in the left subtree part of 3, the first node which I start from is 1. So here the value is 1 and here it is 2. So when I will call the search function again, it will go from here to here, but with in this search function the value remains 2 but the root becomes 1. In the earlier case the root was 3. Now again I will search if 1 equal to null. No, I won't be entering this section. If root dot data, that is 1 equal to 2. No, I won't be entering this section. Now I will add if root dot data, that is 1, is greater than equal to 2, or sorry, is greater than 2. Now my root dot data is 1 because I have entered the left subtree. So 1 is greater than 2. No, so I won't be entering this section. Is if root dot data lesser than value, that is if 1 is lesser than 2. Yes, if 1 is lesser than 2, I will apply the search function with the value but on the right subtree of the root. So 1 is lesser than 2. So I will apply this search function on the right subtree part of the root, that is of this root, right? Fine. Then here the right subtree part, the first value in the right subtree part is 2. So I will search the value 2 and this root dot right subtree returns 2. So again I will go back and call the search function with the value 2 and the root value 2. Now I will check if root, that is 2, equal to null. No, so I won't be entering this section. If root dot data, that is 2 equal to value, that is 2. Yes. If my root dot data, that is 2, is equal to 2, that is the value I want to search for, I will say that it is found and I will simply return this root node, that is 2. Right? So this is the process for applying the searching of any particular node or value in the binary search tree process. At any section, I will check 4 conditions. The first condition, if the tree is null. The second condition, the first root it at each iteration where I will go, is it equal to the value I am searching with? If it is found, then I will simply return the root. Else, if my root value is greater than the item I want to search for, if this is the case, I will try to apply the same search function again in the left subtree part. Else, if my root data value is lesser than the item I want to search for, I will apply the same search function in the right subtree part. And this process will go on repeating itself, and this search will go on calling this search function, and this search function will again call this search function. This process iteratively will go on repeating. Either at a point we will reach a null condition, that is no more values or no more items are there, or we will reach a condition, that is we will get the data at a particular node or a particular root, right? So this was all about the searching algorithm or the searching pseudocode of the binary search tree. Let us try to understand this searching process with this example. So suppose this is my given graph and I want to search for the value of 2. So what does this first line says? This first line says search the value, that is 2, and the root, that is 3. So under this, if root equal to null, is 3 equal to null? No. So I didn't enter into this section. The second part is, if root dot data, my root dot data is 3, is it equal to 2, that is value? No. Right? So I didn't enter this section. If root dot data, that is 3, is greater than my value, so is 3 greater than my value? Yes. Now if 3 is greater than your value you want to search for, then I will apply the search function with the value and the root of the left subtree, that is this part, right? That is this part, left subtree of this 3. So I will again call the search function with the value I want to search for, but with the left subtree part of 3, and the left subtree part, the first root node is 1. So again on this I will apply the same logic. If root equal to null, is 1 equal to null? No. So I won't be entering this section. If root dot data equal to value, that is if 1 equal to 2? No. So I won't be entering into this section. If root dot data is greater than value, that is 1 greater than 2? No. So I won't be entering this section. If root dot data, that is 1 lesser than 2, 1 is lesser than 2? Yes. If 1 is lesser than 2, we will apply the same search function. We will again implement the search function with the value, that is 2, and the right subtree part, that is the right subtree part of this root 1. Okay. In the first instant, I applied in the left subtree part of the root 3. In the second half, I will apply the algorithm in the right subtree part of the root node 1. Right? So, I will call again the search function with my value to be searched true. And in the right subtree part, the node is 2. Fine? So, again, I will start. If root equal to null, is 2 equal to null? No. So, I won't be entering this section. If root dot data, that is 2 equal to value. If root dot data is equal to 2, yes. Now, when the answer is yes, I will simply return the root. That is, I will simply return the 2 value. And once I will return 2, we will say that the item is found. Right? So in this way, this algorithm works, and if the item is present in the tree, it will return the value. And else, two cases can be there. Either the item is not present in the tree, so it will return a null, or the item is present in the tree and the respective item, when it is present, it will definitely return the item. Now, let us study about the insertion algorithm in the binary search tree. Insertion algorithm is that we learned how to construct a binary tree with the given nodes. That means at each and every state with a single node, we perform the insertion algorithm only. Now, let us study what does this insertion algorithm say. Now, suppose I want to insert the value 3. Now, if I want to first insert the value 3, I will first check whether my tree is empty or not. If my tree is empty, I will first make this as the root node. So, my first logic is that insert the value, that is 3, in the root. So, what did I check? I checked that if root equal to null. So, at the first step, yes, my root is null because nothing is created. So, I will simply make the new node as the root node. So, my new node, that is 3, will become the root node and we will return. Fine. Suppose after this, I want to insert another node 1. Now, when I want to insert the node 1, I will again call the insert algorithm with my value that is 1 and my root value that is 3. Now when I want to enter 1, I will first check that 1 is lesser than the root or greater than the root. Now after checking 1 is lesser than the root, I will check whether space is available to include 1 to the left side of the tree. Because while creation of a binary search tree, we have learned that all the nodes lesser will be included in the left hand side and all the nodes greater will be included in the right hand side for each and every particular node. So when I want to add 1 after 3, I will check whether 1 should be included in the left hand side or right hand side. And what is this method of checking? We always check whether the value of the node, that root, that is the value we have at the root, is this value greater than the value we want to entry? If this is the case, then this thing will be included in the left hand side of the root. 3 is greater than 1, so 1 should be included in the left hand side. So value of the root node, if it is greater than the value of the node we want to enter, then this node will be included in the left hand part. Now knowing this, then we will have to check whether left side of this particular root is free or not. That is, if space is available or not. If space is available, then only we can include. If space is not available, then again we will call the left subtree part of this root node. So my next pseudocode was, if root dot data, that is in our case 3, is it greater than the value we want to entry? That is it greater than 1? Yes. Now, if it is greater than 1, I will first check that the left hand side of this 3, is it free or there is space available to enter 1? So, if root dot data is greater than the value, then we will check if root dot left is equal to null, that is left hand side of the root, whether space is available or not. If space is available, we will simply include the new node in the left hand side of the root, that is root dot left equal to new node value and return. So in my case space was available, so I entered 1 to the left hand side of 3. Fine. Now suppose after 1 I want to add 2, then I will again call the insert algorithm with my value 2 and the root node is 3. Now this is the value I want to entry. Fine. Now when I do this, I will again check if my root dot data, that is 3, is it greater than the value I want to entry? Yes. If my root dot data is greater than the value I want to enter, then I will go to the left part of the root. Now when I go to the left part of the root, that is left part of 3, to include 2, I see that the left part is already filled. Now when the left part is already filled, I will then go to this node, that is the left subtree of this 3, right? So if my root dot left equal to null, I included the new node. That is, in this case, first it was null, so I included 1. But in this case, my root dot left is not equal to null. That is, 1 is already included, so I cannot include 2. So I will again call the insert function with the value that I want to enter and the left subtree part of the root. And in the left subtree part of the root, we have 1. Right? So I will again call the insert function with the value 2 and the left subtree part of the root. My left subtree part contains 1. Fine. Now I will check if my root dot data, that is 1, is it greater than 2? No, it is not greater than. So if my root dot data, that is 1, if it is lesser than 2, then I will include 2 to the right hand side of this 1, right? So there was another section. If root dot data is greater lesser than the value, that is, if root dot data, that is 1, this 1 is lesser than the value I want to enter, then I will check whether the right part of this one, is it free or not? That is, space is available or not. If space is available, I will simply include 2. Otherwise, if space is not available, again I will call the right subtree part of this root node. So, since my root dot data, that is 1 is lesser than 2, I checked, that is in the right hand side of the root, whether space is available to include the new node. And I saw that yes, right hand side of 2, space is available to include the new node 2. So I simply included the new node to the right hand side of the root. Fine. Now, suppose I want to enter 5. So I will again call the insert function with my node value 5 and my main root value 3. What will I check? I will check whether root dot data, is it greater than the value I want to search for. My root dot data is not greater than the value I want to search for. Whether root dot data is lesser than the value I want to search for. When my root dot data is lesser than the value I want to insert. When my root dot data is lesser than the value I want to insert, I will simply add this new node to the right hand side of the root, provided space is available. So when my root dot data, that is 3, is lesser than 5, that is the value I want to enter, and if the right hand side of the root space is available, I will simply add the new node, that is 5, to the right hand side of the root. So yes, my right hand side of the root space is available, so I added 5 to the right hand side of the root. Now suppose I want to add another node, that is 6. Now when I want to add 6, I will say insert the value 6 and the root node is 3. Now I will check that whether my root node root data is lesser than the value I want to insert. When my root dot data is lesser than the value I want to insert, I will check whether the right hand side is free or not. If my right hand side is free, I will simply include the new node. And if my root dot data is lesser than the value and if my right hand side is not free, I will again call the right subtree part of the root, right? I will insert the value in the root dot right, that is right subtree part of this root. So when I wanted to insert 6, since my root node value is lesser than 6, I went to search whether the right part is free or not. And when I check that the right part is not free, then I wanted to call the insert value on the right subtree part of the root node. So I will call the insert value 6 on the right subtree part, that is right subtree part of the root node, that is on 5. Right? Now my root node is 5. 5, when is it lesser than 6? Yes. When 5 is lesser than 6, when root dot data, that is 5 is lesser than 6, that is the value we want to enter, I will first search whether the right hand side of 5, is it null, that is free or not. If my right hand side of 5 is free, I will simply include the new node, that is 6, on the right hand side of the root. So when I search that yes, my right hand side of 5 is free, I simply included 6 on the right hand side of 5. And I returned. And suppose these are the five nodes I want to enter. So this is the procedure, or each step the algorithm is followed. And this is the algorithm. That is, what do we do? We first always check for first starting whether the tree is empty. If the tree is empty, for first starting, we make the first node as the root node. Then next on, we go on checking each and every data item we want to enter, each and every data item for 1, for 2, for 5, for 6. Each and every data item we checked whether the value is lesser than the node, root node, or greater. If the value to be entered is lesser than the root dot data, that is root dot data value is greater than the value to be entered, then we checked whether the left part of the root is free or not. If the left part of the root is free, we simply entered the new node. If the left part of the root was not free, we simply again called the insert function on the left subtree part of the root. And if the root data value is lesser than the value we want to enter, we check whether the right part of the root is free or not to include the new node. And if the right part of the root was not free, we again called the insert function with the value on the right subtree part of the root, right? So with this example, I tried to show you how the insertion algorithm actually works on a binary search tree. This is the example I tried to show you, and this is the algorithm or the pseudocode for insertion algorithm in a binary search tree.